ऑफ योजना वी वुड टॉक अबाउट गांधीयन इन्फ्लुएंस द रोल ऑफ लिटरेचर काजी नजरुल इस्लाम एंड द वेरियस राइटिंग्स. नाउ गांधीयन इन्फ्लुएंस हैज़ बीन वेल नोन. वी हैव सीन हाउ नर्मद कॉइंड द टर्म स्वदेश अभिमान द प्राइड ऑफ द नेशन. द इन्फ्लुएंस वॉज हाईली सीन इन गुजराती राइटिंग. गांधी जी रिटर्न टू इंडिया फ्रॉम साउथ अफ्रीका इन 1915 एंड देन साबरमती आश्रम वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 1917 फॉलोड बाई गुजरात विद्यापीठ इन 1920. द टू इंस्टीट्यूशन साबरमती आश्रम एंड विद्यापीठ टुगेदर हैड एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन द फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल. देर वर वेरियस ग्रेट स्कॉलर्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल उमाशंकर जोशी, काका साहिब कालेकर, who were associated with these institutions and had a leading role in the freedom fighting movement. Also, literary works of Ramanlal Desai, Krishnalal Sridharani, Javedchand Meghnani have been important. Some of the poems, for example, poem Gulam, the slave, talks about am I a slave, what is the nature of being free. There were various efforts which have been done. The talks on Gandhi Yuga, the Gandhian era, has been explained. Sindhudu poetry, which talks about collection of Javedchand Meghnani's work, is one of the finest examples. Then we also have the various novels and plays. For example, Bharelo Agni, The Fire Within. And this was a work by Ramanlal Desai. It talked about the backdrop of 1857 freedom struggle. Padarni Tithar, The Pilgrim Prays at the Outskirts of the Village, written by Jayanti Dalal. There were various novels that talked about the entire region. Jabak Jyot, which was again a play by Krishnalal Sridharani, and Agadi by C.C. Mehta. The next was the Mangal Pandey, which is again a play by Jayant Khatri, which explained about the whole incidents of the revolt of 1857, the various tribal uprisings known as Mangar Virag, which has been written against the rebellion efforts, Athamu Delhi, the 8th Delhi, which is again one of the important works. Then we have short stories by Pannalal Patel in the name of National Savings, The Role of Literature. Now, under the role of literature, the Dalit Renaissance emerged in Maharashtra under Savitri Bai Phule, Jyotiba Phule, and then there was Ambedkar's effort. India's literature, press and journalism became important. So, two important acts, the Press Act and Arms Act, came into force. These acts focused on the various implications, the deep consciousness of resistance. Bhartendu Harishchand played an important role. The poem Swapna by Mahesh Narayan became important. The idea of intellectual nationalism, various Hindi writers were taken into consideration. 1885, the rise of Congress and emergence of new intellects, where we talked about the novels like Karwat and Pedian. The Dalit Renaissance, as we already mentioned. Radha Mohan Gokul found some mention in Hindi literature. Then the duration of Bengal partition 1905. Rabindranath Tagore's work, Nazrul's musical drama, which was known as Basant the Spring, focused on it. Then the song composed by Tagore in Gitanjali talks about the peasant culture, the peasant-centered nationalism. There was also a collection of poems mainly in Bengali. Then in the period post-World War I, Gandhian influence became important. Gandhiji went to Champaran and met the indigo farmers. This became a national event and his impact on the rural society was deep. The folk poet of Khadi Boli described the active mindset and the resistance which was done by the people. Quit India movement and the article of Shahid Amin on Chauri Chaura, which was Smriti or Ithihas Chauri Chaura, talks about the people and the farmers wanted Gandhi as a figure who should not only be a coordinator but who should be able to confront the enemies by all means. So the nationalism between 1857 and 1947 was a very important period in Indian history. Urdu literature had similar works. We had the works of poets the names of those who have been mentioned here, Kafi Azmi, Jaan Nisar Akhtar are some of those. Then during the First World War, Urdu poets started having their anguish over the rule of law that came in, the corrupt practices, the loss of human values, and Shahar Ashobi, the urban unrest was explained. Now this pinned This whole urban unrest was penned by various poets. For example, Shah Hatim, Ashfar Ali Fugan, Muhammad Rafi Sauda, and others. There were various battles. For example, Battle of Plassey, where Mir Kazim Shah Alam, Wazir of Awadh, were involved. Tipu Sultan's defeat, Battle of Srirangapatnam. Various poems were written to mourn the death of Tipu Sultan. Then in 1906, there were Calcutta session, which raised the demand of self-rule or Swaraj. Various poets who worked for Home Rule Movement, Agitation, Rowlatt Act. Then we have Qazi Nazrul Islam. Now this was a Ruth Rebellion after the First World War. It talked about the chief vehicle of national movement in Bengal, where literary and political efforts were taken into effort. This was a work by Nazrul Islam, who was actually born in a very poor family in Churulia in Burdavan, West Bengal. And later on, he left school to join the British Army. Many middlemen and poor Indian youth were part of it and looking for a wider world. But the socio-economic message of the Bolshevik Revolution came clear, and Nazrul talked about dipping his pen in blood rather than in ink. And there were various ideas which were depicted, that was on the arrival of Goddess of Delight, which is Durga. There were various lines which were opened for the powerful oppressors, and the earth was explained, preaching the concept of Hindu-Muslim unity. Agnibina, Pralakshika, Chandrabindu were some of the important works where Nazrul's verses were taken into account. He was a musician, non-cooperation movement, and various other movements where Hindu friends were bringing in unity with Muslim friends. So there was the use of words like Rudra, Ishan, which were metaphors for destruction rather than the names of Hindu gods. There was a complete literary set of languages which were developed, and Nazrul's life and creativity has been important effort in this. Now in the form of women or writings by females, Begum Sultan Jahan's work have been important. Shah Jahan Begum's work is again important. Gubar-e-Karwan. Now this is written by Begum Anis Kidwai. This work is again a very important work because it talks about the socio-economic condition of India, the political scenario, and how the things developed. And Begum Qasida Aziz Rasool, the experiences during the British colonial rule, how she served as a deputy president of the council. She was the first Muslim women to reach such a position, and her autobiography became an important source of inspiration. So those were some of the important works of Hindu literature as well as Urdu literature, the various roles of female, and the Gandhian influence in various works. So I hope this lecture was useful. The handouts for those are available at Exam Race current affairs section on the website itself, and below are the links for the same. Wish you very good luck for your preparation. Have a wonderful day ahead.